We start your sports update with football. In the English Premier League, Chelsea have dumped an avalanche of goals on relegation-threatened Queen's Park Rangers in tonight's London's derby. Daniel Sturridge opened the floodgates within 46 seconds of kickoff. Under fire captain John Terry then made it 2-0 with a header from a corner. And Fernando Torres scored a brace to make it 4-0 at the half. That's the way it remains with about half an hour to go. Chelsea and Tottenham, who play later, are looking to pile the pressure on fourth place Newcastle in the race for Champions League qualification. In Spain, Real Madrid stand on the brink of their first La Liga title since 2008. They put on a masterclass in counter-attacking at the Bernabeu to beat Sevilla 3-0 this evening. It means they will take the place if second-place Barcelona lose to Rayo Vallecano in a few hours. Cristiano Ronaldo gave Real the lead in the first half with his 43rd league goal this season. That's already a record with three matches still to play. Karim Benzema scored a quick fire brace early in the second half to seal the victory. Next, basketball in the first round of the NBA playoffs, where the top-seeded Chicago Bulls championship hopes have already taken a blow. They're one up in the best of seven series against the Philadelphia 76ers, but at a price. Star point guard Derrick Rose is out for the rest of the season after hurting his knee. The reigning most valuable player has struggled for fitness, missing 27 regular season games through injury. After a quiet first quarter that the Bulls led, he caught fire in the second, dominating on the inside.
Derrick Rose beginning to heat up right now. To the shoot.
And on the outside, this three-pointer giving Chicago a 20-point lead in the fourth as he top-scored with 23 points. But moments later, he crumpled to the court after an awkward landing. Medics say he tore his anterior cruciate ligament. Elsewhere, the Miami Heat scorched the New York Knicks in their first game. In the Western Conference, Oklahoma edged defending champions the Dallas Mavericks by a point with less than 2 seconds on the clock. Singapore has emerged as the overall champion at the 7th Southeast Asian Youth Athletics Championships. The two-day event at Bishan Stadium saw nine countries competing. For the first time, there were three new categories: overall team championship and best male and female athletes. Singapore fielded the most athletes, 81 out of 280. And with points awarded for participation, the host collected 305 to Thailand's 228 to claim the team championship. But Thailand topped the medal tally with 11 goals. Singapore won just one goal, courtesy of Jana Wong, in the 100 meters hurdles. We take you now to an indoor field of vibrant flowers, a piece of installation art inspired by Singapore's botanic gardens. And its scenery is constantly changing thanks to visitors making their mark.
Each flower, each leaf, comprising a myriad of fine glass pigments painstakingly applied to sheets of felt. Zoom out and you get this, a carpet of florals and colour. There's also a reflective piece on the wall. Moment and Eternity is the latest work of art by Japanese artist Shinji Omaki.
Eternity is infinite, I think, infinity, because infinity is maybe a big circle. But this is like one moment. People come in and one moment, one time, and that moment is gone every time. Infinity is every time moment gone.
And the reason is that Omaki might have spent what seemed like an eternity, 10 days, creating this, not to mention months preparing the design. But the whole idea is that viewers interact with it, walk through it, trample on it even, and ultimately change it.
I think people will be very wowed visually because it's just really beautiful and it covers the whole space. But then they'll also have another surprise element because they will have to actually participate in this show. So they're the ones really making this work together with the artists as time goes on.
People coming and maybe very carefree and very happy, and but so many flowers gone, but not gone.
They're just evolving. Amaki usually uses kimono-inspired florals, but for this piece in the Hermes Gallery at Orchard Road, he's used flowers from different countries in a nod to Singapore's melting pot of cultures. The colours are even inspired by the island. Those who walk through the art are making their mark on different cultures and changing them to some extent. Amaki says this represents real life, and he invites everyone to come along and help shape this piece of culture in their own unique way. The show is on until... 唯望途经多少失约或失眠，偶尔在心中忆起某诺言，已是隔多年。人人求新追赶，总各自发展，回头留低多少感慨或感言，信若愿一天可实践兑现，然又再耳边约定某天某月某年某落各点再遇见，彼此境况就算改变，连习惯也改变，期望你笑脸再多点，记住某天某穿梭，转眼数十年，沿途延伸多少牵挂或牵连，记挂在当天可实体碰面，无时亦相见。约定某天某月某年某落日点再遇见，彼此境况就算改变，连习惯也改变，期望你笑脸再多点，记住某天。就算改变，连道理也改变，和你不变。雨后晴天，再没风险，听到你声线，平复了我胆战。明天方想见面，总可日见。明天。
June. Finally, China has set up the first protection and research center for red pandas. The site in Chengdu is starting with 20 of the endangered animals. Officials hope to increase that to 100 within 5 years. Only 20,000 red pandas are believed to survive in the wild. They are native to southwest China and the eastern Himalayas. And here's something else you don't see every day. Workers at this panda sanctuary play dress-up for a serious course to blend into wilderness training for baby panda Tao Tao. He's the world's first panda born to a captive-bred mother in a semi-wild environment. And he's being raised with as little human interference as possible. This program was created after it was found that pandas bred in captivity were unable to survive on their own when they were released. And that's News 5 tonight. Good night.
On this incredible rampage through those outrageously slimy stores is the guy who makes any mall a party, our pal, Hal Park.
Hey, everybody. This is it, the Treasure Mall. Right here, we're going to play the fastest, messiest, most wicked game on TV, where our players can pick up some really great prizes. And one of our teams is going to get a shot at busting open that incredible Treasure Mall treasure chest full of fabulous stuff, including a trip for the family to Colorado. All right. We'll see John Denver. So, Let's check with Ed and see who's hanging out in the mall today. Ed, who's hanging out in the mall today?
Well, Hal, first, give a big welcome to Kimberly and Matt Cole. Kimberly's 7 years old and just loves animals. Matt is 9 and wants to be a news reporter.
All right. Done any news reporting lately?
Well, yeah, because I am a reporter for a local children's newspaper called the Bear Central News, and I report for that. And just recently, I received an award out of 250 people for first place in the newspaper division.
Correct.